Hello and welcome to the MIGRO YouTube channel. My name is Shane and I'm the founder of MIGRO. In this video, we're going to look at how high to hang your grow light above your plants in order to get maximum yield and the healthiest growth. Previously, we've looked at a classic setup of a 600 watt HPS with an adjust-a-wing defender and a 4x4 grow tent. And we demonstrated that the optimum hanging height for this light in this environment is 40 centimeters or 16 inches above the plant canopy. We also demonstrated that by lowering it or raising it just 10 centimeters or 4 inches from that optimum hanging height will have very significant impact on the grow. So by dropping it just 10 centimeters, you get significantly more power light, but you get into the zone where the light intensity directly under the fixture is far too high and is going to damage your plants. Too high being above about 1,000 micromoles per meter squared per second of power light. Raising it 10 centimeters above that optimum height and you get a 8% reduction in the amount of light reaching your grow, which is going to translate directly into yield. So you get an 8% reduced yield. So This hanging height and fine tuning it and getting the optimum for your lighting setup in your grow environment is really, really critical to maximizing your yield. So where do we start in optimizing our lighting setup? The first thing is we want to hang the light as low and close to the plants as possible. The reason is that the higher you hang the light, the more light is spread out the sides, as you can see here with this 600 watt HPS and adjust-a-wing defender. A lot of the light is getting spread out to the sides. Now in your grow environment, this light will be getting reflected back down onto your grow, but there will be reflectance losses. So you will get light that is going out to the side and either missing your plants and being lost or hitting a reflective surface and only partially coming back. So we know we've got to lower our lighting fixture down as close and get it as close to the plants as possible to get the most light down onto our grow. But it is a trade-off, and the trade-off is getting it as low as possible without damaging the plants. And how do we prevent damaging the plants? Well, we look at the species of plant that we're growing and determine what is the maximum level of light that that plant can use and still grow healthily. If we're looking at medicinal herbs, for example, in flowering stage, that maximum power level is going to be in around 1200 micromoles per meter squared per second. And that is the power level that we have in our 600 watt HPS setup at 40 centimeters underneath the center. So that there is 1200 micromoles there. The reason we are adjusting the light with the center measurement is because that's where the light intensity is going to be greatest. As we move away, obviously it's going to fall away. So we're measuring here, we're bringing it up to the maximum it can be without damaging the plants. And then the rest is going to be less than that. We know that that's going to still be healthy growth. So in this instance, I'm using a power meter, a quantum sensor. These are moderately expensive. This is about $300 or $400 for this unit. Very accurate, very reliable and simple to use. It's an Apogee SQ500. You can get ones which are very close in terms of accuracy. There's a Hydrofarm one, which is about €150. And I've tested it against this and others, and it's quite accurate. So it's not hugely expensive and can be very, very beneficial in terms of your yield and productivity. If you don't wish to invest in a quantum sensor, there are other methods of adjusting the light down to as close to the plants as possible without getting damage. Other ways to detect if your plants are going to get damaged is to measure, again, directly underneath the light source, the temperature of the leaves. You can do this using a budget infrared thermometer. This one is about €20. And you would position the light as low as you think is suitable. And then after a few minutes, take the temperature of the leaves directly under the light. They should be at or below the room temperature. The reason is that the leaves are respiring or sweating, and by doing that, they should be able to lose their surface temperature at a greater rate than the environment around. And so they should be, as I said, at or below the room temperature. If they're above, it's showing that they're not able to dispel the heat as quickly as it's landing on them, and effectively they will get burned. Over a period of time, if you left the light there in that position, you would see the leaves start to curl, and probably they would brown and dry up and die. And the same effect would happen to the flowers if they're positioned directly underneath. So a very nice and easy way to do it. The other way is much more crude, but can still be effective, which is the using the more sensitive parts of your hand or your arm and positioning under the light until you start to feel discomfort. And really you're just doing the same thing as doing the leaf temperature measurement, but a cruder form. To summarize then, in order to get the best out of your grow and maximize your yield, you need to hang your grow light as low as possible. You're doing that to minimize the amount of light that will escape your grow or be lost through reflectance losses. The trade-off you have to manage is having your light as low as possible while also not damaging your plants. You determine whether damage is going to be done to your plants by using a number of different methods. You can get a quantum or power sensor and adjust so that the center point or the maximum level of power intensity is no more than 1200, and you do that in the center. You can also look at leaf temperature and use an infrared thermometer and determine in just a few minutes whether the either the leaves or the flowers directly under the light are at receiving too much light and heat and are likely to be damaged. Or the other way, last remaining way, is that you set up your light, adjust it as best you can, and you come back and you check afterwards to see, is there leaf curling occurring? Is there bleaching or browning of the leaf tips or the buds? In which case, you know you've got it too low and you're going to have to raise a little. Once you have determined that optimum hanging height, the next thing is to make sure that you maintain it. And this means as your canopy raises, as your plants get bigger, that you continually adjust the hanging height of your light to make sure that it's always at the optimum. And this will ensure you maximize your yield and get the best out of your grow and your grow light system. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please subscribe and take care.